Hey everybody, hope you're doing well. It's good to see you. Today we're going to talk about the circle of fists. I know, it's music theory, sounds scary, but trust me, it's not. All right, so let's go over to the whiteboard and we'll get started. Okay, so now that we're at the whiteboard, we're going to talk about the circle of fists. Hopefully the lighting's good. I don't have a great spot for this, but what we have here is a circle, obviously, and then there's notes around this. So a basic understanding of how scales are built comes in handy when you're working with this, but not necessarily required. So if you print one of these off and it'll have a lot more on it, which we're going to get to, but you don't have to build these yourself. You can look them up, print them off, then you've got them. But I'm going to kind of explain what the circle of fists is, how you can use it, some tips about it and tricks that you can use for writing songs and how it kind of works. All right. So as you see here, we've got notes going around the outside here. And what these are, we'll start with the C right here. As you go clockwise, this is why it's called the circle of fifth, you're going to go a perfect fifth up. So if you're in key of C major and you go up a perfect fifth, you end up on a G note. All right, so C to G is considered a perfect fifth. And if you continue on, G to D is a perfect fifth. And then if you go in the key of D major, D to A is a perfect fifth. So like in key of C, you got, just write it up here, C, D, E, F, G, A, and B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Your G is your perfect fifth, okay? Same way if you go around. All right, let's get that off there. And that's why it's called the circle of fifths. As you go clockwise around this, you're going up in increments of fifths based on the major scale. So, and if you go counterclockwise, you're going to go in fourth. So that key of C, a perfect fourth is an F. And the key of F major, a perfect fourth is a B flat. So this way, clockwise, you're going in fifth. If you go this way, you're going in fourth. Okay? Not a great artist. So clockwise, going in fifth. Counterclockwise, you're going in perfect fourth. All right, and I won't get into why they're perfect fifths or perfect fourths today. That's not a lesson about intervals and whatnot, but that's how that works. That's why it's called circle of fifths. As you go around, starting with C, you're going in fifth. Or start any of these. As you go clockwise, you're going in fifth around. Okay, so let's talk about keys, like a key of C or a key of G. These would be considered major keys. We're going to write major up here. Okay, so I'm going to show you a couple of tricks about this. Now, if you understand your theory and you understand relative minors, every major key has a relative minor key. And you'll see on the circle of fifths, they're usually written this way. The key of C, or I'll do it in lowercase, the key of A minor is all the exact same notes. It's relative minor. So we're going to write minor in here. We're going to go around the circle. So key of C major, its relative minor is an A. The key of G, its relative minor is E minor. The key of D, of course, is B minor. The key of A is F sharp minor. Let me put a little F. Of course, the key of E is C sharp minor. The key of B is a G sharp minor. I'm putting these on lowercase because they're minor keys. And then down here, it's always written this way, G flat, F sharp. That is, it's the same key. F sharp is the same as G flat. It's just how you want it. Depending on what you want to call them, whether you're using it as a flat key or a sharp key, they're the same thing. And F sharp has a relative minor of D sharp. And the key of G flat has a relative minor of E flat. They're the same thing. D sharp. Let me write that a little better. D sharp, E flat, same note. All right. The key of D flat, relative minor is B flat. Key of A flat is an F. Key of E flat major, C is its relative minor. B flat major, G is its relative minor, G minor key. And the key of F major, its relative minor is D minor. All right. So, like I said, you have to have a little bit of understanding of theory to understand this. But so as you go around and talking to not just notes right now, not notes of perfect fifths, but actual keys, the key of C, key of G, key of D, on the inside of the circle of fifth is its relative minor. So the key of C major and the key of A minor have the exact same notes. C, D, E, F, G, A, B. Okay. Key of G major has G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp. And so does the key of E minor. Same exact notes. So they're called a relative minor. They're identical. It's just depending how you focus around playing them, whether it's in the key of E minor or G major. That's all. So that's what the inside of the circle of fifths are. These are your minor keys that are correspondent to the major keys. Okay? So let's continue on here. Let me use a different color here. And what we're going to want to talk about next is the sharps and flats. And what you're going to see, I'll go like this. Key of C has no sharps or flats. They're all no, like if you look at a piano and you lay it out, all the white notes are A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. No sharps or flats. The black keys are all your sharps and flats. So key of C major has none of those. The key of G has one sharp. All right, D has two. I'm gonna explain it in a minute. A has three sharps. E has four. B has five. I'm gonna explain what they are here in a second. And F sharp has six sharps in it. And you're going to see, so if you see a sheet of music, if you see a sheet of music and you're going to see it staff at the beginning, you'll see one sharp, two sharps, three sharps. Sometimes you see flats. I'll get to the flats in a minute. This is what they're, I got my notes up here for you. Keep them down to C here. I can show you. Like, key of B has five sharps in it. I'm going to explain what those sharps are and an easy way to remember them for you. Okay. So, like I said, C has no sharps or flats. G has one. And how you know what sharp that is? You start with an F. It's going to have an F sharp. Okay. D has two. It's always going to repeat. So it's going to have the F sharp. It's going to have a C sharp. It starts going this way. It starts with the F. And it starts going that way around. So D is going to have F sharp and C sharp. That's its two sharps. Key of A has three sharps. Just repeat them. F sharp. C sharp. What's next? G sharp. Okay. Then E has four sharps. Same thing. F, C, G, and D. Just write in order. F, C, G, and D are your four sharps. Key of B has five. One, two, three, four, five. Just right around. F, C, G, D. My head's not in the way there. And then A. And then the final, the six sharps. It's one, two, three, four, five, six. All of those. So F, C, G, D, A, and E. Those are all your sharps as you go around that way. Flats. Let's use a different color. Those are sharp. So the flats are going to start kind of like here and go that way. You'll see. Key of F has one flat. And that's a B flat. Okay. Key of B flat has two. And it's B and E. E has three flats. I'll just write them so you know. Four flats. Five. And then six flats. And as you go around, like I said, starts and it just continues this way. So B and E. B, E, A. As you continue around, B, E, A. These are all flats. And D just continues in this order. B, E, A, D, G. And then the last one, B, E, A, D, G, and C are all flat. Those are the flat notes in that key. The key of G flat, B, E, A, D, G, C are all the flat notes. So, and that goes B, E, A, D. So you can kind of see the pattern. Sharps, start with F sharp. Next one is C. They just go around that way. And a good way to remember that, if you remember in the flats, it would be bead, just like wearing beads. And then G, C, F, good, clean, fun. That's how people remember it. That's a C. So if you want to memorize the flats in order, if it's one flat, it's B. If it's two flats, it's B and E. If it's three flats, as you go across, bead, and then good, clean, fun, G, C, F. All right, and then the sharps, how people remember that typically is a lot of people remember it this way. That's an E down there. F, C, G, D, A, E, B. It's backwards. But if you want to remember it, fat cats get drunk and eat bugs. So it's just this, just backwards. You can see they're just mirror images of each other. B, E, A, D, G, C, F are your flats. And then fat cats get drunk and eat bugs are your sharps. Pretty simple to remember it. So what this means is, I'm saying, is key of C has no flats or sharps. Key of G has one sharp, which is the F sharp. Key of D would have two sharps, which is the F sharp and the C sharp. Key of A has the F sharp, C sharp, G sharp as you go around. So this is a good way to remember how all 12 keys, how many sharps are flat in each one. Of course, you can remember all these, but it's easy if you just have this chart. That's what makes it nice. That's how I want to write that on the inside here. I know a lot of these just by memory from playing different songs. Not typically these ones over here, but like key of F, C, G, D, A, and E. These ones right here, not so much B. I don't play key of B a lot, but these keys, these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 keys here, I kind of know them by heart just because I've played so many different songs in those keys. But let me see here. This one right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many sharps and flats? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six. That's just how many flats, how many sharps. Okay. Which actually we're gonna do that in red, just visually. Like I said, you can print these off. There's all different variations and colors and ways to memorize it, but like I said, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sharps. And then for flats, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now, one of the cool tips I wanted to show you here is, let's take some of this off, get some of that coloring out of there because that doesn't really matter. It was just direction. What I want to show you, one of the neat tips that I've found this to be useful, is when you're writing a song, you want to know what chords are in that key to work with. This can be very useful. All right. And let's just take the key of C, no sharps or flats, and we'll just use that real quick. What I like to do is, you're going to see this a lot of times, and we'll put those lines on there just for you to see it. It's going to be broken up into like little, let me put a little point here, and then you're going to have, get that out of there, kind of like this. All right. right, so kind of like that. And you're gonna see the, let me do the circle around it too. We'll just, part of my artwork here, I'm just gonna kind of wing it, but the circle's gonna kind of look like this usually. And that lines, those lines come out. I didn't really build this to scale, but you'll get the point. This is how it kind of looks when you look at them. Okay, pardon my, this wheel went on a rocky road. Okay, what I want to show you, the one of the neat tricks I found with the circle of fifths is when you're writing songs and you want to figure out what chords are in that key, you can actually do this. You take your key center, so we'll say key of C. We know this is a perfect fifth, so we'll use the Roman numeral. That's your perfect fifth. This is your perfect fourth. So this is, and this is your one chord. So that's the one, the four, the five. So blues, C, F, and G, those are your 1-4-5 chords. All right, this is your sixth, your minor sixth. The D minor is your two chord. And the E is your three, minor third. So this actually gives you your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 chords in that key. Now there's a seventh one, which is your diminished, not used very often. A lot of times it's used as a minor 7 flat 5. Don't need it for this, but this will give you 6 of the key, the chords in that key. So basically, if you kind of block it out, kind of like, you know, you take this, these are your 6 chords in that key of C. C, D, E, F, G, and A. Your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and your 6. You do the same thing over here, key of G. We'll just take key of G. Let me erase all this. Okay. Key of G is going to be our 1. To your left is your 4th. To your right is your 5th. So you got your 1, 4, and 5. You got your 6 down here. E minor is the 6 of the G. You've got your 2 and your 4. Or I'm sorry, your 3. And when you know chord families, you kind of understand this. This is your relative and subdominance, dominance, but that's for a different subject. So in the key of G, these are your 6 chords. Minus the 7th, which is a diminished and we rarely use it. So you'd have your root G, your 4th is the C chord, your 5th is the D, your 2nd is the A minor, your 6th is the E minor, and your 3rd is that B minor. And you can put those chords all together to make a chord progression to write a song. Those are the chords that are in that key, and you can go all around the circle and do this with any of them. You take whatever key you're in, you know, key of A, and you pick the to the left of it, like this way, and to the right of it, and then the minor chords that go with it, and those are your chords. So that's one of the neat tricks I've found with the circle of fifths. It's coming really handy. But yeah, it takes a little bit to get wrap your head around, and so you got to kind of understand how scales are built, majors and minors, natural minor scale, but that's what it really is. It starts with the C. This is always where you start, and you work around clockwise. You're going in fifth. Counterclockwise, you're going in fourth. The inside is just your relative minor keys to that corresponding key, A minor and C major. Same exact notes. And then how many sharps or flats are in each one. And that is determined, like I said, starting 0, 1, 2, 3 as you go around. And it just starts with the F, C, and then those sharps are what are added in. So if you laid out a key of G, G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, G, those are the notes in the G major. And that's how it's laid out. And these are just little tips on how to remember it. Like the bead, good, clean, fun, or fat cats get drunk and eat bugs. I don't know who, I've seen that one. That's how I remembered it. But they're just mirror images of each other, just going, whether you're going sharps or flats, to the right or to the left. All right, so that's the circle of fifths. I hope that helped clear up some confusion for you, and I'll see you guys next time.